In question number 16, the pressure of the monatomic gas varies with volume as P equal to P naught e raised to the power V, where P naught is a constant and V is the volume. Then the specific heat of gas is, and R is the universal gas constant. We know that from first law of thermodynamics, delta Q is equal to delta U plus delta W. So NC dT is equal to NCV dT plus P into dV. So if I calculate the value of PdV, we know that for an ideal gas, PV is equal to nRT. So if I differentiate this, PdV plus VdP is equal to nRdT. So if I calculate the value of PdV, it is given in the question, P is equal to P naught e raised to the power V. So if I differentiate this, dP is equal to P naught e raised to the power V into dV. So if I substitute the value of dP, then I can write P naught e raised to the power V into dV is equal to nRdT, and here is PdV. So this P naught EV is written as P. So on taking PdV common, it can be written as 1 plus V is equal to nRdT. So we can substitute the value of PdV. So PdV is equal to nRdT divided by 1 plus V. So NCdT is equal to NCVdT. So from here, the value of C comes out to be CV plus R divided by 1 plus V, and the value of CV is 3R by 2. So option 2 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 17. In question number 17, a fluid having thermal coefficient of volume expansion gamma is filled in a cylindrical vessel up to height H naught. The coefficient of linear thermal expansion of material of vessel is alpha. If the liquid is heated with the vessel, then find the level of liquid with temperature when temperature increases by delta T. So if the temperature is increases by delta T, and if I consider the area of the cylinder as A naught, then the initial volume of the liquid is A naught into H naught. So if the temperature is increases by temperature delta theta, the volume of the liquid becomes A naught into H naught into 1 plus gamma into delta theta. And this volume must be occupied in the volume of the cylinder if the height of the liquid is H. So if I write this, the area of the base of the cylinder will become A naught into 1 plus beta into delta theta. So 1 plus beta can be written as 2 alpha into delta theta, and let the height of the liquid in the cylinder is now H. So from here we can calculate the value of H. So it comes out to be H naught into 1 plus gamma delta theta divided by 1 plus 2 alpha into delta theta. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 18. In question number 18, a large heat source is at temperature T naught. Heat is transferred from this source to a body of mass M and a specific heat S through a cylindrical conducting rod of length L and thermal conductivity K as shown. The area of cross section of rod is A and there is no loss of heat to the surroundings. Then the time in which temperature of the body changes from T1 to T2, and it is given that T0 is greater than T2 is greater than T1. So we know that dQ by dT is equal to KA T0 minus T. If at any time T, let the temperature of the body is T, then I can write KA T0 minus T divided by L, and that must be equal to the rate of heat gain by the body. So ms dt upon dt. So from here I have to calculate the time. So dt is equal to msl divided by ka into dt upon t naught minus t. So at t equal to 0, the temperature of the body is t1, and at any time t, the temperature of the body becomes t2. So on solving the value of t, it comes out to be MSL divided by KA ln T0 minus T1 divided by T0 minus T2. So option 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 19. In question number 19, choose the incorrect statement about the waves from the following. So first statement is mechanical wave may be transverse as well as longitudinal. So this is the correct statement. Non-mechanical wave like electromagnetic wave is always transverse. That is true. Longitudinal waves are always mechanical. So this is also true. Transverse wave can be generated in solid, liquid and gaseous medium. So this is incorrect statement because the gases does not provide the restoring transverse force. So option 4 is the incorrect statement. So the correct answer for question number 19 is option 4. Let's move to question number 20. In question number 20, a transverse wave pulse is given by the equation yxt is equal to 1 upon ax minus bt whole square plus c, where abc are positive constants. Consider the following statements. Pulse is traveling in negative x direction. So if I see the coefficient of x and t, they are of opposite sign. So the wave is traveling in the positive x direction. So option A is wrong. At t equal to 0, pulse is symmetric about x equal to 0. So at t equal to 0, the function becomes f of xt becomes 1 upon a square x square plus c. So we know that this is a symmetric function with respect to x. This function is like this. So this statement is correct. In option C, at t equal to 1, pulse is symmetric about x equal to b by. So whatever is the logic we applied in option B, the same logic will apply in option C. So option C is also correct. The amplitude of wave pulse is C. So the amplitude of wave pulse is 1 by C. So option D is wrong. So the correct statements are B and C. So option 3 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 21.